Welcome to today's Alumni Career Services webinar, hosted by the Georgetown University Alumni Association. Thank you for taking time out of your day to join us for Midday Meditation, Mindfulness in Your Workday with Susan Lakatos. I'm Allie Heal, the Associate Director of Alumni Career Services, and I'll be facilitating today's session. As a reminder, you may use the question section of your GoToWebinar control panel on the right-hand side to let us know if you're having any technical issues. Now, on to our presenter. Susan Lakatos is a business and executive coach who combines more than two decades of business expertise with creativity and mindfulness. She has more than 25 years experience as a dedicated practitioner of mindfulness and meditation. Susan has lived on staff at two retreat centers, spent 6 months in India studying with a prominent guru. She teaches meditation and mindfulness and is a graduate of the prestigious two-year Mindfulness Meditation Teacher Certification Program of the Greater Good Science Center at the University of California, Berkeley. She is a Georgetown alumna, having graduated from both the College of Arts and Sciences with a Bachelor of Arts and the Institute for Transformative Leadership as a certified leadership coach. She holds an MBA and an MA in psychology, both from Columbia University. Without further ado, I'm pleased to turn things over to Susan.
Thank you very much, Allie, and welcome everyone today to our lunchtime meditation. We are working today with a concept in meditation that is directly addressing the issue of being pulled in different directions and feeling stressed and having just too much going on, the chaos of a busy day. And this concept is what is traditionally referred to in meditation and mindfulness as the monkey mind. If you've ever been to a country where they have wild monkeys in Asia or South America or wherever it may be, if you sit and watch them for a while, you'll notice that they're never still. They are constantly chattering. They're constantly jumping from one tree to another. They're constantly running along one branch and jumping to the next. They're constantly running up and down the trunks. They're constantly chasing each other across the ground. They are just never quiet. And this is a traditional natural way for the human mind to work. The human mind is just never quiet, hence the term the monkey mind. We are constantly thinking this, we are constantly thinking that, and then we get distracted by something else and we get pulled over here. We all have this experience with our phones. We pick up the phone to look up something very reasonable when we pick the phone up, and then we get distracted by something else, and then it links to this, and before you know it, we're looking at a video of some person we've never heard of, and 20 minutes have gone by and we have no idea what we did with those 20 minutes. That's the monkey mind. The mind is constantly jumping from one thing to another. And the people who design our phones and who design internet sites and internet algorithms have a lot of neuroscience that teaches them how to hijack the natural human tendency for the monkey mind and turn it to their profit and their advantage. But on our side, we have several thousand years of teachings on how to manage the monkey mind and how to take control back from the monkey that hijacks our mind and runs to random TikTok videos, and to bring peace and calm back into ourselves, our center, and our mind. So what we're going to do today is to teach you a technique to work with the monkey mind. And the first step in gaining control over the monkey mind and taking back control of our brain hijacking us is to learn to separate ourselves and our awareness from our thoughts. And that's a new concept to a lot of folks, because we can get so caught up in the various things that we're thinking and the various different things that are running through our heads that we never notice that the thoughts are actually separate from our awareness of the thoughts. And once we're able to create that space and create that separation where the thoughts are out there doing the thing that the thoughts do, jumping around and behaving like monkeys because that's how thoughts behave, but our awareness and our sense of self and our own peace and tranquility is over here, calmly watching the thoughts go crazy, then we're able to have peace and calm in ourselves, even as the monkey mind is off doing what the monkey mind does. We can create that space we can create that separation. We can create peace in our own selves while the monkey mind is not at peace, because the monkey mind is never at peace. So the technique we're going to do today is to create that awareness, create that space, create that peace. And we're going to begin with a bit of relaxation to sit comfortably in our chairs or sit comfortably on the ground or lie down if you want, whatever physical position makes you comfortable. Do a little bit of relaxation to make our bodies comfortable, and then we'll begin to address our attention and our awareness towards the monkey mind and towards creating some peace and some calm and some space between us and our awareness and the monkey mind. So let's begin. So begin by finding a comfortable position in your chair, on the ground, lying down, even walking if you'd like, whatever position enables you to be both relaxed and alert. Maybe you need to settle into your seat a little bit and shift your weight around. Maybe you want to, you know, roll your shoulders or stretch your neck, or whatever you need to do for a moment to actually kind of settle in comfortably into whatever position enables you to feel peaceful and relaxed and yet awake and alert. And as you do that, we begin to bring our awareness and our attention to the breath. Noticing the breath as we breathe in and as we breathe out. Simply becoming aware of the sensation of breathing in and breathing out, bringing our attention, bringing our awareness to the rhythm of the breath, the sensation of breathing as the lungs and the belly expand as we breathe in, and as the lungs and the belly deflate as we breathe out. Focusing our awareness on the breath, bringing our attention back to the breath. And as we begin to anchor our awareness in the breath, and anchor our attention to the breath, we begin to focus on parts of the body and how the body is feeling in this position, this comfortable position that we've selected. And we focus our attention first to the feet, noticing how the feet are feeling, the feeling of the feet against the floor, the weight of our body pressing against the ground through the feet. And we relax the feet. Maybe we decide to tighten them as much as we can, curl the toes, tighten the feet up, and make them into tight, tight, tiny little balls, and hold that tension for a moment, and then release. Releasing the tension from the feet, and feeling it flowing out of the feet and into the ground. And then we move the attention up to the legs, noticing any tension we may be feeling in our legs, any discomfort, any heat or cold, noticing the sensations of the legs, and releasing all tension from the legs. Maybe deciding to tense them really tight, as hard as we can, and holding that moment of tension for a boat, and then releasing. And now we bring attention to the lower body and the buttocks as our hips, settling our hips in, noting any tension, any discomfort, any sensations of temperature or pressure, and releasing the tension from the lower body and the hips. Maybe tightening that area as much as we can, clenching the buttocks as tight as we can, and holding that for a moment, and releasing the tension from the lower body and the legs and the feet, flowing out into the ground. And now we bring our attention to the upper body, to the chest, to the heart, to the shoulders, the shoulder blades. Noticing any tension we may be feeling there. Noticing any sensations of comfort or discomfort, temperature, pressure, whatever we may be feeling in the upper part of the body. And maybe we decide to tense that part of the body as much as we can, squinching our shoulder blades together, pulling our shoulders in and tightening up as much of the upper body as we possibly can. And holding that tension for a moment, releasing it, and letting it flow out through the rest of the body into the ground. And now maybe we do the same attention to the head and the tops of the shoulders. Noticing any sensations in the head, any tightness in the jaw, any stiffness in the neck, any tension in the forehead and the eyebrows. And maybe we decide to tense the head and the shoulders and the neck as much as we possibly can, squinching up our eyebrows and clenching our jaw and being as tight as we can in the head and the neck and the shoulders. And holding that position for a moment, releasing the tension and letting it flow out through the body into the ground. And finally, we draw the attention to the arms. Noticing any sensations in the arms, any feelings of tension or discomfort, any sense of pressure or of temperature. Whatever sensations we may have in the arms. And maybe we decide to tense our arms as much as we can, holding that as tight as we possibly can for a moment. And then releasing the tension in our arms, allowing it all to flow out through our body and into the ground. And as we do that, we take one last look at the body, any areas of the body that may still be feeling some tension, that may still be feeling some tightness or some discomfort. And maybe we draw our awareness to that part of the body, tensing it again if we would like, holding that tension once more for a moment, and then releasing all of that tension, all of that stress, all of that discomfort flowing through the body and into the ground. And as we do that, as the tension flows out of the body into the earth and dissipates throughout the universe, we bring our attention back to the breath. Anchoring once again in the breath, noticing the feeling of breathing in, noticing the feeling of breathing out. Noticing the sensations of the breath going through the nostrils or out through the mouth. Any sensation of cold, if you're breathing in some chilly air in this January day, or any sensations of warmth as you breathe the hot air from your body out into the chill. Noticing the flow of the air through your nose, down the windpipe, into the lungs, and the filling of the lungs as you breathe in. The filling of the belly as you breathe deep into your belly, allowing the belly to expand with every in-breath and to release with every out-breath. Noticing again the sensation as the breath releases, flowing out of the belly, out of the lungs, up through the windpipe, and out across the mouth and the tongue and the teeth. Just being aware of the rhythm of the breath. And as you bring your attention to the breath, and you focus on the sensations of breathing and the awareness of breathing, you may notice thoughts starting to cross into your mind. The thought may be, I still have that report I have to get done this afternoon. Is this thing going to end? I don't know when I'm going to be able to get that report done. I don't know how I'm going to get this done. I'm the boss. And as that thought comes by, just notice the thought that you're having a thought and watch it go by. If you like, you can envision yourself sitting on the edge of the river, sitting comfortably on the banks in whatever position you enjoy, calmly and peacefully noticing the breath, drawing your awareness to the breath as you inhale, and drawing your awareness to the breath as you exhale. And as you sit meditating comfortably and quietly on the riverbank in your mind, you notice the thoughts floating by in a little boat, maybe, or maybe they float by the river on a log, or maybe your thoughts are a piece of paper and the piece of paper floats by. Whatever form your thought takes, whatever form your thought uses to manifest in your mind and floating by the river of your mind as you sit quietly meditating on the shore. Noticing your thoughts coming in, noticing the thoughts floating by, and then noticing the thoughts floating away into the distance, gone. And then perhaps another thought comes in. Maybe this one is about needing to get something for dinner and forgetting to have put the dinner out to thaw during the day, and what are you going to do when you get home? Or maybe the thought is about something in the family or a conversation you had with someone. But whatever the thought is, noticing it coming into your river, noticing it floating by, noticing it floating away down the river, releasing it, releasing you. Goodbye, thought. As you sit quietly, peacefully, on the side of the river, just noticing your thoughts. And after you notice a thought come into the river, float down the river, and float away, we bring our attention back to the breath, focusing on the sensation of the breath, focusing on breathing in, focusing on holding the breath for a moment, focusing on breathing out, aware that the thoughts are flowing along the river of our mind. Aware that the thoughts stream by, but unaffected by them, unattached to them, separate and calm and peaceful on the banks of the river of our mind. As the thoughts float in, and the thoughts float by, and the thoughts float away. And as you notice a thought, noticing awareness of the thought, but noticing awareness of the fact that you are not that thought. That thought is not you. That thought is separate and floating in and floating out and floating away as thoughts do. While you, yourself, your awareness, the infinite awareness that you are, that contains those thoughts, that holds those thoughts, that witnesses those thoughts, but that is not those thoughts. While you, the infinite awareness that you are, sit quietly, peacefully, undisturbed, untouched, unaffected, just watching the thoughts float by. Watching the thoughts and bringing the attention always back to the breath. Bringing your awareness back to the breath. The breath that is always there when you need it. The breath that fills you without you even needing to pay attention to it. Opening to receive the breath. And then feeling the lungs and the belly inflate and expand as the breath flows into your body. And then feeling the breath exhale out of the belly and the lungs, out through the windpipe, out across the tongue and the teeth, through the lips and the nose. Noticing the breath, the infinity of the breath that is always there, that always sustains you. That always supports you and fills you. The rhythm of the breath that flows in and flows out without you needing to do anything to cause it, without you needing to do any work to make it happen. Just the infinity of the breath flowing in and flowing out. And as you sit comfortably meditating on the riverbank, noticing the thoughts floating by, bringing your awareness back to yourself, back to the breath, back to the infinite awareness that you are, the awareness that is not those thoughts, that is separate from those thoughts, that is next to those thoughts, detached from those thoughts, untouched by those thoughts, safe on the riverbank, safe and secure away from those thoughts, calmly watching them float in and float by and float away. Knowing that you are not those thoughts. Those thoughts are not you. And the thoughts rise unbidden, and they fall away unbidden, leaving you the infinite eternal awareness that you are, untouched, unaffected, containing those thoughts and not being contained by them. That you are the infinite container that holds those thoughts and watches those thoughts and notices them flowing by as you bring your awareness always and again, returning to the breath, the eternal motion, the eternal rhythm of the breath flowing in and the breath flowing out, filling your body, filling your lungs, supporting you, unbidden and unasked for, and then flowing out again as you exhale, releasing from the body, releasing from the lungs, taking away all this tension as you exhale. The eternal rhythm of the breath flowing in, flowing out. The infinite awareness, awareness of the breath, awareness of the thoughts, awareness of yourself being aware of the breath and the thoughts, but noticing that you are not them and they are not you. You are not those thoughts. You are not the breath. You are the infinite and eternal awareness that contains all the universe, that contains the thoughts, that contains the breath, that contains the awareness of itself, holding and containing all of those things as you sit infinitely calm, infinitely peaceful, at rest in the infinity of the universe, noticing the phenomenon arising and falling in front of you as the thoughts arise and fall away and flow down the river, as the breath arises and fills the body and flows out, and as you, the infinite awareness, sit calmly on the riverbank, noticing it all. If you'd like to stay with us and continue the meditation, please feel free to do that. Or if you need to bring yourself back into the world and to get back to the rest of the regular day, feel free to bring yourself gently, calmly, gracefully back into the room whenever you are ready. And to know that you can do this technique whenever you'd like, for 20 minutes, for 2 minutes, or just for a moment in the middle of the thought, and bring yourself back to the riverbank, watching the thoughts float past, knowing that you are not those thoughts. Those thoughts do not control you. Those thoughts do not contain you. Knowing that you are the infinite awareness that sits calmly on the riverbank, watching the thoughts float by. Hoya Sacks, everyone.